Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Auto Club Speedway right here in beautiful Fontana, California, right here for this 2 mile racetrack here, the ButtKicker 200. You saw the ads in there just a second ago about ButtKicker premier racing setups. We'll be talking about them later on this evening. Good evening, folks. I am the redneck announcer, Jake Reeves. Got the Australian Dean Biggles up here giving us some awesome producing up here. And also William White will be on the call with me here this evening for the Nazareth 360 Racing Network Concerns of Police Survivors Truck Series, folks. It has been a fantastic past 2 weeks. I've been out there actually getting into the truck, trying to get warmed up, kind of get a feel with some of these guys out here at the track. But there you see before you the schedule. You got Auto Club, you got Milwaukee, then you got Daytona, and then after that, we're going to see who's going to be in that top 20 and see who's going to be out here trying to run for a championship this season, season 8. William, we are here at Auto Club because this place right here is absolutely a fantastic race. We'll talk about the track here in just a second, but now we're getting up to the grid. And how about this? Out of nowhere, we got a pole sitter of Craig Schroeder up here on the pole. Got it by 0.04 of a second with a 40.145. And to his outside, the Joker, Joey Doucette. He'll be starting outside of row number one. Tyler Detmer, a part-timer and also a host on the Hot Lap podcast, which just come out here this evening. He's going to start P3 with last season's champ and the rookie of the year from last season's champ, Jeff Merck. Chris Sinnaman and Jason Morales, they will be in row number three. Zach Hartwick and Brian Chu will start in row number four, seventh and eighth, respectively. And the boss man, Brady LaBeouf, he's going to start P9, and to his outside will be the 19 of Adam Newton.
Row six is going to have Matthew David Wood. Had a brilliant performance last week, at Legacy Texas. He starts 11th with Ed Osborne on his outside in 12th. The Dean of Deans, Dean Doucette, will start 13th with Justin White in the 2 in 14th position. Tyler Daniels will round out the top 15 with Stephen Thomas on his outside in the number 23. Mark Morton in the 8 will start 17th with Raul Mesa on his outside in P18 with Keith Bradley and Michael Moultrie rounding out the top 20.
Then we got Cody Knott. He's going to start P21. Robbie Richards will start in P22. Phil Pappas, 23rd. Jose Luis Rivera, 24th. Brandon Broadfoot, 25th. Eric Zimmerman, going to start P26. Hutt Wigginton in the double zero, he's going to start P27 with Lucas Whitehead starting in P28. Devin Painter, 29th, rather. And Casey Mink, that rounds out the top 30. Those are the drivers that took a time. The rest of these drivers did not take a time, that being Nathan Scott, Chris Blanchard, Joshua Rodriguez, CJ Fondale, Brandon Bullock, and Brandon Cooper. TJ Moore is the race control for this evening. William, this place, I talked about it a while ago, this place, obviously a lot of fans hate to see this 2 mile oval go away and go to a short track. But, you know, give you an idea, William, as we look at the standings, William, give everybody an idea of how this race is going to unfold and everything about this racetrack.
Well, it's going to be super tight, as you saw on the starting grid. Everyone set a time, so that's the top 30 were all within 0.3 of a second. The top 10 were all within just a few hundredths of a second. So it's going to be a super hotly contested race. You see those top six, Keith Bradley down to Jose Luis Rivera, they are all locked in to the postseason playoffs, all with wins. Matthew David Wood in P7, he is leading the non-winners. He's 149 points above the cut line with just 3 Dash for Cash races to go before these playoffs begin. But the Bubble Boys, Ed Osborne, Raul Mesa, Zach Hartwick, those are other guys to be looking for as we're about to go green here to start the second Dash for Cash race here at Auto Club.
Here we go. We're actually going to get you a little bit of an idea for the race info as they are working their way off of turn four. They're going to take 2 laps. So next time by, they're going to get them lined up and pretty much going, I guess you could say. There you see it right there. Going to be three stages, rather. 20, I believe that is 55, I believe, for stage number 2. And then it's going to go all the way to lap 100. And, folks, I mean, honestly, you know, William, I was talking about this as well, this track. Much like where the DSR Electric Truck Series is going to be at Monday night at Michigan, This place is very, very spread out. It's very wide. I mean, you can go four wide and sometimes even five wide. The restarts absolutely gets straight up crazy as hell sometimes on these restarts. That's something we're really going to be looking out for tonight. But also some stuff that I was talking about in the pre-race. Tyler Dittmer up here, obviously a part-timer with the number 31 truck. Obviously got the Murph's Magical Creations on that truck as well. And also the host with Brady LaBeouf on the Hot Lap podcast. And also Jason Morales, talked about him a second ago, sitting back there starting in the sixth spot. He was the guest this past week on the Door Banging Download on Spotify, hosted by myself. So everybody go over there and check that out. It's an absolute blast. Jason got in there. Me and him talked about a lot of stuff. Had a lot of fun with it, but did get into some personal stuff as well, especially in that We Got Beef segment. So everybody go check out those two podcasts, both of them on Spotify. That is the Hot Lap Podcast and the Door Banging Download, both of them on Spotify. But, folks, here we go, folks. I'm happy to be back up here in the booth. Everybody out there in the live chat, good evening to you guys. Everybody, let us know who you think's going to win this thing. Is the Pace Truck starting to pull off? Fred, as we've been told, the Pace Truck pulls off. Barney, the flagman, holding the green flag. Craig Schroeder, the Joker, Joey Doucette, they are on the front row. Green flag is in the air. We're racing here at Fontana. Schroeder down on the bottom. Tyler trying to see if he can get up and give him the shove. But on the outside, Jeff Merck is going to damn near end up turning Joey Doucette as hard as he is pushing him side by side. Wheel to wheels, they work their way off of turn two.
Fairly even start for everyone there. We saw Doucette and Schroeder get off to a fairly even getaway, but now we're going to see some super speedway-like bump drafting. You see Jeff Merck putting the bumper to Joey Doucette, getting him clear for the lead. The 60 almost gets himself up into second place. We're not quite Schroeder, though, battling back on the bottom of an offset three wide there. Schroeder back to the lead. The inside line looking very potent there in these opening stages. We're three wide for the lead. Schroeder's going to lead the first lap.
Three wide for the lead. Merck stuck in the bottom. Joker Joey Doucette up top. Tyler Dittmer trying to go to the middle. Maybe try to make it work. Chris Sinnamon, the spice man down here on the bottom side. Now they fan out two wide for about the first five rows, give or take, all the way back to where Adam Newton and Zach Hartwig back here battling it out. Up front, Jeff Merck trying to run the top side. He's getting the shove. The Joker Joey Doucette shoves him. Jason Morales going to take it all the way up to the penthouse, trying to run the Kyle Larson line on the top side. But Merck gets away. He's trying to keep hold of that lead. He's Joker Joey Doucette trying to go down to the bottom and maybe make a pass going into one.
Yeah, we're seeing guys like Jason Morales trying to experiment with different lines. We're seeing them ripping the fence. We see Brian Chu up there as well in the 51 Toyota. So experimentation is going to be the key here. See what line is fastest at any given time. But Joey Doucette got a big shot there from Jeff Merck a lap ago. That's allowed him to get clear for the lead. But here comes Jeff Merck now. He looks to the inside of the Joker Joey Doucette as we ride on board with the NASCAR champion into turn three. He gets the lead. He's clear of Joey Doucette. Jeff Merck now to the lead end of lap three.
Yeah, and he made a very, very aggressive move right there, William. I mean, he went all the way down to the bottom, slid all the way up to the wall. Now here comes the pole sitter, Craig Schroeder, down on the bottom. Tyler Dittmer riding on board with the Murph's Magical Creation Chevrolet Silverado. Now Schroeder down on the bottom. Like Merck tried to pinch him down on the bottom side, but Merck's going to be able to get the run. Joker Joey Doucette slammed Schroeder. Slammed him right in the tailgate. Holy hell, I'm amazed Schroeder was able to hold on to it. Now he's actually going to take that bump. He's going to try to go to the lead. Merck up on the top side. Joey Doucette right behind him. New leader here at Fontana is Schroeder, but now Merck trying to side draft and try to get the lead back.
We're swapping positions every which way. Jeff Merck's going to just about squeak that lap lead over Craig Schroeder there. They're side by side now into turn one. Joey Doucette in tow. You see Tyler Dittmer there as well. Jason Morales making up a couple of spots there. He's looking for fourth place on the outside of Tyler Dittmer. I have to run off. Joey Doucette now looking to the inside as we ride on board of the deck lid there of Jeff Merck. We're looking back there towards the 56 of your pole sitter Craig Schroeder as he moves to the inside of Jeff Merck. That's your new fight for the lead, as it was a lap ago. It's Schroeder on the inside, Merck on the outside. Merck doing a brilliant job there of making the outside line work, but we'll probably see some three wide moves soon enough as they see Jason Morales to the outside of Joey Doucette trying to make his way up to third place.
Yeah, he's really trying to make this top side work. We already saw him earlier, basically up there on the Kyle Strickler, the high side tickler for some of you dirt fans out there. The high side tickler, Kyle Strickler, he's running it all the way up against the fence, and he's going to get the run, but he's got nowhere to go. Schroeder stuck right in front of him. Now Tyler Detmer right behind him. Here comes Brian Chu. Brian Chu going to see if he can follow Tyler Detmer up here as well. Everybody following Jeff Merck, trying to find a line, trying to find a way and get around Jeff Merck, but I'm telling you right now, William, they have been racing their asses off this whole time. It's like it was the last five laps, and we're only seven laps into this 100 lap race.
Yeah, absolutely. They're certainly dashing for the cash, but they want to get their momentum early. There's only 20 laps in this first stage. Stage points are on the line at very early doors. See Craig Schroeder pulls a little slant job on the champion.
Oh!
Gets into the side there of Joe Doucette as Merck tries to avoid with three wide for the race lead. They're door banging still. Merck and Schroeder up on the top side. It's Joe Doucette now down on the very bottom. There's Brian Chu. He's up four places on the start. A brilliant start for Brian Chu. He gets overtaken by the Dean of Deans. Dean Doucette gets temporarily up to third. So it's an electric start there. Oh, Doucette, who's up nine spots since the drop of the green flag. But it's still Jeff Merck holding strong on the outside with pressure from Joe Doucette and Craig Schroeder behind.
Tyler Detmer's pick to win here tonight at Auto Club. Dean Doucette has jumped all the way up here and shocked everybody, really. I mean, he started 13th. All the way up to fourth. Another driver up here started 20th. He's all the way up to seventh. Michael Moultrie, he is all the way up here in that 11 truck. He's stuck in the middle of a three wide battle. He's got Chu down on the bottom. He's got Detmer up top, up front. Jeff Merck trying to see if he can hold on. The Joker, Joey Doucette. Schroeder stuck up top. Here comes Morales. Jason Morales in the one, right in the middle, and just straight up chops down across Dean Doucette's nose. Holy hell, that could have been a big one right there. Could have been a caution any way, shape, fashion, or form. And now Morales going to ride the momentum on the bottom side to challenge Merck for the lead. But Merck going to get the momentum on the top. Here comes Doucette on the top now.
Doucette giving a shot to Morales, trying to get him moving on that low side as the momentum from the high side works to the favour of Merck and Doucette up top there, running on board of the roof of the number 25 of Dean Doucette. See the 56 of Craig Schroeder, see the 11 of Michael Moultrie, who's made up 13 spots since the start. Make that 14 as he's about to squeak past Tyler Detmer there as he gives a shot to Doucette, coming down the front straight, but still Jeff Merck in the lead. Joey Doucette though trying to make a move for the lead. There you go, into turn one, still running on board with Dean Doucette. See Jason Morales down there on the low side. Doucette clears Jeff Merck, but Jeff Merck will have the run. He chops back low. Craig Schroeder now going to be under pressure from Dean Doucette. Does Dean move low? Yes, he does. To the inside there of the 56 goes Dean Doucette, trying to continue his upward momentum through the field. He's now on the inside of Joey Doucette.
I'm telling you right now, folks, these guys are basically racing at 180 miles an hour and racing like they're in downtown Atlanta on I-75 right now. Straight up aggressive as hell up here at the front. And way back there in the back, it's aggressive back there with Keith Bradley trying to get up here. How about Brady LaBeouf? Back there, I just saw him there for just a second, the 24. He stuck it three wide. Where the hell did Morales go? He was all the way up there at the front. Now he's shot like a cannon all the way back here where Brady LaBeouf is. We got wrecking up at the front. Dean Doucette, I think he got into Schroeder. Craig Schroeder in the 56. He ends up going around, no caution on the Speedway. Now Dean Doucette, he's going to slide back. As your pole sitter, Craig Schroeder got hit in the left rear and got spun around. No caution on the Speedway, but Joker Joey Doucette trying to get some draft and have a shot to pass Merck going into turn one.
Yeah, no hazard for these guys. Unfortunately, Craig Schroeder from the pole all the way down to pretty much dead last there. But as you see, they'll come to eight to go at the stripe in this first stage, so everything needs to be laid out on the table very soon. As you see, further back, we're focusing on the 51 of Brian Chu. He's got Brady LaBeouf just behind him. He's now got Brady LaBeouf on his inside. He's now got Brady LaBeouf ahead of him. Big send there from the boss man, Brady LaBeouf. He's up to eighth. There's almost four wide. They're up top there near the fence. The Spice Man, Chris Cinnamon there in the three. But we've got three wide there further back for P15.
I'm telling you, wow, holy hell. And now Stephen Thomas down here on the bottom. He's got Broadfoot up on the top side. It's Nathan Scott. But we work our way back up here where Tyler Detmer trying to run that top side, trying to get something going. Adam Newton, he started 10th. He's all the way up to top five. How about that right there? How about Martin Morton? We didn't talk about him earlier on. He started 17th. He's up here trying to work his way up into the top five. And just like William White said just a second ago, folks, playoff points will come in just a matter of about six or seven laps when they end up hitting the line right here. Seven laps from now, we will have a caution and we will get to that stage one break. Right now, it looks like it's all Jeff Burke, but we see a couple of guys back there, Brady LaBeouf, trying to take a shot down the bottom. Everybody starting to migrate up to the top side. Newton up here with Morton, they're trying to run the middle, but the front four trucks, that being Merck, Doucette, Moultrie, and Detmer, all of them run the top coming off right there.
Yeah, we're seeing a lot of experimentation there. But here comes Joe Doucette now. He had a run on the high side behind Jeff Merck. He had the slipstream. Merck trying to pinch the 16 down low to stop him getting that run. Here comes Michael Moultrie. He started 20th. Now he's third. He's got a massive run on the 16 truck. He ducks low. Doucette tries to throw the block. He moves higher, Michael Moultrie. Doucette again blocks. He gives a shot now to the Joker, Joey Doucette, trying to see if he can work his way up towards the fence. Michael Moultrie putting on the burners early on here, as he's got Newton and Dittmer just behind him. He tries to get to the inside of the 16. He gives him a little tap now, but the 19 of Adam Newton is trying to get in on the party as well.
Wow, holy hell, I mean, that's some aggressive moving right there. And Dittmer, he sent Moultrie, tried to send Moultrie down on the bottom. Or maybe Moultrie just ended up saying, screw it, I want to make a shot at it. Now he's going to get stuck three wide. Adam Newton on the bottom side. Moultrie is going to end up getting passed by Tyler Dittmer. Now Morton up top, three wide. Moultrie comes down, almost a little bit of door banging with him and Adam Newton. Now Joker Joey Doucette, he gets a kick in the pants. Dittmer hits him right square in the tailgate. So Doucette down to the bottom. Now Dittmer going to see if he can try to get the run on the top side. And now he will get there. So Tyler Dittmer on the top side. He's got help from Mark Morton. Joker Joey Doucette, he has no help. But Dittmer trying to get this spot as now Morton starts to work down to the bottom where Joker Joey Doucette is.
Yeah. Mark Morton is on an absolute tear right now as he gets into the wall. He got a little bit tight there off the corner, trying to get
forward.
There's trouble. Big one on the front straight.
Just before the straight. Going around. Holy hell, he's able to get it almost up on the binders. Tries to jump back down. Somebody almost ends up T-boning him. Caution out right here at the end of stage number one. And folks, I think that may be stage. So I think Jeff Merck will end up getting the stage one win after a four wide gone wrong coming off of turn four. Holy hell. I'm telling you right now, Dean, we're going to have to get an instant replay of that right there because these guys, like I said, they were hard, hard aggressive right there, trying to get every inch that they could. And it ended up right there with Adam Newton end up going around.
Yeah, I think the day of Morton there getting into the wall trying to get past Joe Doucette might have been what triggered that accident. We've seen a replay here. He got a massive run coming down the back here, and he's slipstreaming the 31 there of Tyler Dittmer. He gives a little shot to Dittmer there, getting into three. He's trying to work the outside, comes to the inside. You see the run he gets from arcing wide. He gets a massive run, just gets a massive wall of 30 out of 16. Might, of course, a little bit of a check up. There you go. All of a sudden, they're four wide, not expecting it. And it's on from there. Massive impacts there for about half a dozen trucks there involved.
I think exactly what happened right there, Dean, if we could go back and see this right here. Morton obviously ends up getting up into the fence. And then, obviously, Moultrie, every one of them trying to see if they can get around. And I think Moultrie right here was really the one that actually started the whole deal. You could say Morton was the one that started it because, obviously, he hit the damn wall right there in front of him. But on the right side, you're going to see Moultrie try to force this hole. Newton, he sees that Brady LaBeouf is on his inside. Moultrie ends up trying to shove it three wide, and he's not able to do it. He ends up getting in to Newton. Then he goes up. He gets into Morton, comes back down, gets Newton, and ends up spinning him around. And then Morton, he's basically a double whammy in this whole instance. After fencing it the first time around, he ends up getting thrown up into the fence. There you see Newton. He ends up getting the worst out of all of it. Holy hell, I think it was Chris Cinnamon that almost ended up tagging him. But everybody, looks like they are going into the pits right here. So we'll see what happens right here in just a second when they get back out on the track, folks. Don't go anywhere. We're going to take a quick break.
Creations, home to custom laser engraving and gifts. This veteran-owned and operated company engraves for all occasions. If you want one of Murph's magical creations, call the number on your screen or commission through either Instagram or via email. Murph's Magical Creations, made with love for you.
One, seven. Folks, we're back here at Fontana. Obviously, there you see Jeff Merck. He ended up getting the stage wet. I'll see if I can try to bring him in real quick, get a quick word with Jeff Merck. Jeff, wow, Jeff, congratulations on that stage one win. Just want to get a quick word with you. How's the truck feeling out there on the racetrack?
Well, it felt good before I got run over going on the pit road, so I don't know now. I got almost 40 seconds of damage. But I don't know. I'll have to wait and see. I'm probably not the best interview right now.
All righty. Well, Jeff, hopefully we'll be talking to you soon then, buddy. Good luck.
Hi, man. Thanks.
Bad timing, I guess, right there with folks on that one bringing him in right there. Obviously, we didn't see him getting tagged in the back end. And obviously, from what I'm seeing, the back end does look like it is a little bit crinkled up. So, obviously, went in first. He's going to end up coming out fourth. He's going to be the second truck on the outside. That means we got a new leader. And guess who it is? It's the Joker, Joey Doucette, who ended up finishing second in that last stage. Tyler Dittmer going to be to his inside. How about Brady LaBeouf, the boss man, not up to third. Mark in fourth. And Brian Chu, he is the defense spot. Here we go. Green flag, stage number two here at Fontana. And the Joker, Joey Doucette, he's going to be able to get a fantastic jump and jump right down in front of Tyler Dittmer. Dittmer's going to give him a kick in the pants. Brady LaBeouf now down on the bottom. Dittmer thought about going to the top side, but Brady LaBeouf down on the bottom going to work some magic down there as Dittmer gets loose. He ends up getting tagged by Mark. Mark head on into the fence. Holy hell, everybody's scattering trying to get around. Caution on the speedway after Tyler Dittmer ends up getting loose. And Mark tags him in the back end, and then everybody, chaos happening off of turn two here at Fontana.
Yeah, it's a massive one there to begin the stage. And that's going to result in a big water damage for a lot of good trucks there. That's going to very much jumble up the field. We'll see the replay here. It's all stuck up a little further back from the front row. Come into the green. We saw Joey Doucette get off to a lightning start there with Tyler Dittmer on his inside there. Got a good jump. Just about cleared the 31. Got down as soon as he got over the start and finish line so as to not incur a penalty there for the 16. We're going to focus on Jeff Merck and Tyler Dittmer. That is where this accident starts there, just behind the 16 of Joe Doucette, just on the outside of Brady LaBeouf there. We see Tyler Dittmer just gets loose, nowhere for Jeff Merck to go. Brady LaBeouf just gets tagged a little bit. Chu's involved, Robbie Richards, Jason Morales. Half a dozen trucks avoiding it. Big damage there for a lot of good trucks.
Yeah, look at all these guys right here, William. Everybody coming off of turn two. Awesome camera angle right there by Biggles, Dean Hopton. Seeing every bit of that right there. I mean, guys are just coming around the corner damn near blind, honestly. If they're up on the top, they may have somebody in front of them. And then there's just nowhere to go. So you see a yellow flag and you're like, well, where's it at? And then all of a sudden, bam, you just run right up on it. So you just got to dart left as hard as you possibly can and hope like hell you don't get into it. But, I mean, William, you called it right there on the money, really. I mean, Joker Joey Descent gets a fantastic restart, able to jump down. And that's something that we really wasn't expecting. Obviously, the long run here with these guys, obviously, it's going to get tight. But on the early point of it, especially coming off of two, you can really slip. Is if you was watching right there where Tyler, he actually slid up a little bit, tried to overcorrect it and try to bring it back down. You're already seeing him already getting a little bit out of shape. And then Jeff Merck's got nowhere to go. And watch this, Brian Chu just absolutely nowhere to go. Runs right into him. Wow, where the hell did that come from? That was some stuff afterwards right there. I think that was the three of Chris Sentiman ends up getting involved in this as well. So another wreck that happened, besides the one that we just saw with Tyler Dittmer and Jeff Merck.
Yeah, we saw Matthew David would have a massive impact on this outside or inside wall, beg your pardon, 38. That Zach Hartwick also had a major impact there. You see his grill completely torn off Brian Chu with some big damage. Adam Newton as well. It's Matthew David Wood, Tyler Dittmer started in third. Jeff Merck started fourth there. With some big hitters taking some big hits, some big damage. That's going to really jumble up the field. Joey Doucette's going to lead him to the green on this next restart.
And absolutely. I mean, you know, an MDW back there, Matthew David Wood, you really hated to see that from Matthew David Wood, because obviously from what happened last week at Legacy Texas, a little, you know, I guess you could say a little bit of door banging that was going on right there with Stephen Thomas. Hate to see it for him. But there you see the standings right there with some of these guys. And right there is Zach Hartwick. You see that name right there in the 21st spot as far as the points goes. Zach Hartwick in the 38, he got involved in that accident. When all hell ends up breaking loose, Hartwick, he tried to make a devastating move down, and Morales, he ended up hitting Hartwick, and then Hartwick come down, got in MDW, and obviously Brian Chu ends up getting involved in it as well. So a lot of guys right there, pretty close to that cut line, obviously Zach Hartwick there as well. A lot of guys getting involved in that right there. Just an accidental, that could have happened to anybody, folks. Just that little bit of a step out, I guess you could say, with the back end of the truck, just stepping out. Even the best end up losing it and not being able to hold it. So, it's hard to say on that one right there. I mean, it is what it is. And you hate to see somebody end up getting took out of that, especially with a lot of guys out there getting took out. Hello to some of you out there. We got Dan Gobble, Jeff Sickles. Let's go swim. They got the rock on sign right there with Jeff Sickles. Everybody in the Nazareth chats knows I love to throw up that rock on sign as well. And obviously we got Zachary Taylor out there. Let's go Scoob. And any of you knows who Scoob is, that is Stephen Thomas out there. And also Don out there. Don't poke the bear. Well, Don, I think we poked him just a little bit too much because he ended up getting caught up in that accident. But here we go, folks. Everybody coming off of turn four. Green flag is in the air. And the Joker, Joey Doucette, he's going to take the bottom side. He's going to get a fantastic jump. Brady LaBeouf up on the top, got nowhere to go. How about the animal? Keith Bradley in the 29 from 19th to 3rd. And how about Robbie Richards up here, 22nd up to 4th as they work their way off of turn two?
Yeah, seen some big movers there. Keith Bradley, the animal, up 17 positions. Might be 16, though. It's Brady LaBeouf there. Makes a big move there to the inside of the 29. He's looking to move into second place. There's Thomas and Richards there fighting for 4th and 5th. Riding on board now with Robbie Richards. He's got Stephen Thomas in the 23 just on his inside there. Single file for now. Between the top three positions. But here comes Brady LaBeouf looking for the lead behind Joey Doucette. Now we're going to go 3 wide. The animal, Keith Bradley, looks like a big move for the race lead. He's into first place for the time being. On your ticker there on the bottom right, Joey Doucette might have to concede first and second, but it's going to be LaBeouf and Bradley side by side for the lead on lap 26.
Yeah, and Brady LaBeouf's going to be able to get the run, and now he's going to get the shove from the Joker, Joey Doucette. Brady LaBeouf all by himself, he's got the lead. The Joker up on the top side. The animal down on the bottom. One laughing up top and one of them growling down on the bottom side. Stephen Thomas. How about old Scoob right here? Started 16th. He's up to 4th. Where is Shaggy at out there? I got a feeling it's Zachary Taylor right now. As Stephen Thomas has worked his way up into a battle for the 3rd spot with the animal Keith Bradley. Now the Joker trying to take a shot, trying to go up to the top side. Brady LaBeouf has to jump up and make the block. Is Bradley still by himself on the bottom? Here comes Scoob on the top side, and here comes the Joker for the lead, going into three.
Yeah, Joe Dusek trying to take back that lead from the boss man, Brady LaBeouf there. You see him working the inside there, trying to clear the 24. We've got Stephen Thomas waiting in the wings, going to have a decent run there. Dusek clears for the lead, but here comes the 23 as Robert Richards tries to look for a move on the animal. Keith Bradley riding on board with Thomas now as LaBeouf tries to give a shot to Joey Dusek, tries to get that outside line moving. Here comes Stephen Thomas now, big power move, already into second place as LaBeouf tries to work the very high side there off of turn number two. He's going to get a decent run there, but Stephen Thomas does a good job at hanging on for the time being, but he's not got much help behind him as LaBeouf gives a big shot there to Dusek to clear Dusek for the lead. Here comes Keith Bradley.
And how about this right here? How about the six back here of Nathan Scott, folks? This guy started in the 31st spot. He's all the way up here trying to battle with Robbie Richards for a spot inside the top five. How about that? Get you a little bit of power right there in the JBL truck. How about you? And check out right behind him. How about Phil Pappas and Justin White? We haven't talked a lot about them. Phil Pappas, there you see him back there in the 85, running all the way up against the wall. Justin White down the bottom. That is a battle in itself for the seventh spot. But up front, Stephen Thomas down on the bottom trying to take a shot. We may end up seeing Nathan Scott trying to get up here as well. No, that was Robbie Richards in the 48. So now, Stephen Thomas down on the bottom. The Joker, Joey Doucette, Scoob, and the Joker going for it here at Fontana.
Stephen Thomas up 14 spots from the start, currently occupies P2. But look at the run that Keith Bradley's got on these two up in front of him. Massive momentum coming off of turn four for Keith Bradley. Running on board now with Brady LaBeouf, working that outside. He's got Stephen Thomas there, Nathan Scott just behind him, but it's Keith Bradley and Joe Dusek leading the wave. But Stephen Thomas works the inside. He's doing the shorter distance around the racetrack. Bradley trying to door bang there, Stephen Thomas. They're racing hard with 70 laps to go. Just 25 to go at the stripe here in stage number two. So still all to play for. It's Keith Bradley and Stephen Thomas fine for P2. But it's Joey Dusek clearing the lead.
I'm telling you right now, it's like I said earlier on, folks, with a little bit more door banging right here at the front. Bradley and Thomas not wanting to give an inch, and neither one of them wanting to give a damn right here, coming to about a quarter of the way, give or take, here in this race. Thomas down on the bottom, Bradley up on the top side. Brady LaBeouf, Robbie Richards, Martin Morton back here almost got stuck in a four wide batter. No, that's Nathan Scott, excuse me, in the six. He almost got stuck in a three wide predicament with Pappas and Justin White. And how about Devin Painter as well? 29th up to 10th. Pappas way up the track, and Raul Meza in the 37. Some new players coming to the hole as Pappas is going to get turned by Painter coming off a four.
Pappas in the 85, he was up 19 spots. That's all that hole that's going to be undone. We're going to stay green as Pappas is down in the grass. So again, no immediate hazard to these drivers. Does not warrant a yellow flag. So Phil Pappas' hard work of getting up the field is all undone. Joe Doucette still in the lead, but Keith Bradley now giving him a shot. Brady LaBeouf tries to move to the inside of Stephen Thomas. That's a fight for third. LaBeouf up five positions. Thomas up 13, now 12 positions as LaBeouf looks to make the move for third place behind them. Nathan Scott, easily your biggest move of the evening. Up 25 positions after starting 31st. We ride on board with him now. Robbie Richards, two drivers left. LaBeouf and Thomas, two abreast in front of him. He's looking for fifth on top of Robbie Richards going into turn one.
Telling you right now, the beef may not be over with the Joker, Joey Doucette, and the animal, Keith Bradley. Obviously, earlier they was doing a little bit of door banging, and Bradley thought about trying to get up here and give him another shot. How about right behind him? Thomas tried to make a move. Brady LaBeouf threw the block on him, and Thomas had enough of driving skill to be able to get down there and have a shot to try to get around him. No pun intended anyway to Stephen Thomas, because he is one hell of a driver here in the Concerns of Police Survivors Truck Series. He's able to get down on the inside. Brady LaBeouf, now he's up on the top side. Animal of Keith Bradley trying to catch Joker, and here he comes. Keith Bradley going to take a shot on the inside. He's going to try to pull the slider if he can, and that's exactly what he's going to do. The animal, Keith Bradley, is going to take the lead. Joey Doucette almost ends up tagging the fence. And Brady LaBeouf, he's going for third on old Scoob up here with Stephen Thomas.
Keith Bradley with an awesome move there. Very potent there from the animal to take the lead. Joey DeSets gives him a push into turn three. But look at Stephen Thomas. Pinches Brady LaBeouf and stops him. Brady is going to box now. He's coming down into pit road. So he's going to relinquish that P3. Getting very early in the stage. But here comes the guys behind him. Vondel, Schroeder, Knott, Morton following him in. So start of this pit cycle, I believe.
Yeah, this right here may be a little bit crazy to see right here because obviously they're going 15 laps right here, folks, which obviously that is about right on the fuel of how these guys is going to have to be able to make it. So this is regular scheduled pit stops right here for a lot of these guys. You got Brady LaBeouf down on pit road. You got some other drivers actually down on pit road as well, I believe. You got CJ Fondale. You got a couple of Mark Morton back here, Cody Knott, Brandon Bullock. Phil Pappas, he's still on pit road, but here we go. Keith Bradley, he's going to end up going right by every single one of these guys. You got Scott Painter, Chris Sediman, guys coming out of the pits, and the leaders, they're going right by them. Is now we got a battle for the lead. Stephen Thomas and Keith Bradley, the almost door bang coming off a two.
Keith Bradley trying to keep Stephen Thomas down on the low side. Keith Bradley seems to be a fan of the high side, as of current Joey DeSeto, former leader of this race, not going to give it up easily, but Stephen Thomas working that inside beautifully clears Keith Bradley. Bradley's going to try a bit of a crossover, try and maximize his exit speed to retaliate, but he's going to put his bumps to the 23, try and get that line moving as their single file. So what's this pit cycle now? We might see some guys boxing soon.
Yeah, I got a feeling there's going to be a lot of them easing down pit road as they just go by. Devin Painter in the 99. Just went down and got his service done. Keith Bradley now down on the bottom. Thomas as well. Joey Doucette, Robbie Richards back here. Got a little bit of action back here behind him. I believe that was the 20 of Jose Luis Rivera, if I'm not mistaken. Almost ends up going around. And he's going to be able to keep it straight. It's now CJ Fondale, one of the 40 truck. This right here, folks, this is the difference. We got some good tires and we got some worn out tires with some of these guys back here in the back trying to get back up here and get that lap back. But Rivera being very aggressive with some of these guys as you see some of the battling going on up here. Looks like the top five trucks, Thomas, Bradley, Richards, Doucette, and Justin White, they're breaking away from the field.
Yeah, they seem to be the only guys who have yet to stop during this current stint of the front runner. Stephen Thomas still leading the way behind or in front of Keith Bradley, Robbie Richards, Joey Doucette, and Justin White there. That's your top five. You'd imagine in the next sort of half a dozen laps or so, when the fuel economy starts to run out in these Craftsman trucks, that these guys will start to come down pit road. But look at Rivera and Doucette side by side. Rodriguez as well involved in that battle for what is sixth on the racetrack at the minute.
I'm telling you right now, Bagel's up here. He's just trying to get D. Doucette to get up here and get inside the top five. We hear him in our ear a bunch. Come on, D. Get that 55 up there. He's trying to merge him or trying to get him going as much as he can. He's in a side-by-side battle with Jose Luis Rivera. And how about right behind him? You got the 56 right back there. That is Craig Schroeder trying to get something back from what happened earlier on in the race. Unfortunate for him of how his race has been so far this evening. But he's on that strategy with CJ Fondale and Morton and Painter and Knott and Bullock, all those guys. As now they're three wide. Schroeder down on the bottom, Doucette and Rivera up top. Almost some door banging between Doucette and Rivera as they work their way into turn one. And how about this? Right in front of them, Joshua Rodriguez got a little bit of strategy going on in that number 32. Started 30-30s, he's all the way up to 6. But now we see a little bit of movement up here. Stephen Thomas trying to hold on. Keith Bradley and Robbie Richards, they're going to take a shot at Thomas going into 3.
Hey, Keith Bradley got an awesome run there off of turn 2. Got into the slipstream of Stephen Thomas and shot to the inside of the 23. Trying to make moves before the pit cycle here in stage number 2. See Robert Richards in third there. Raul Mace as well in the fray, but he's a lap down, scored at 20th. See Robert Richards on his outside. Right on board now with the Fraternity Police Survivors car of Justin White there, the number 2. Currently seated in position number 4, the 37 of Raul Mace. Is scored one lap down in P20, as I mentioned earlier. Robert Richards just behind him, waiting in the wings. But Stephen Thomas, Keith Bradley, still side by side going into turn 3. See Keith Bradley, big dive into turn number 3. on the inside there. Stephen Thomas now hangs around the outside out of turn four. Stephen Thomas retains the lead.
I'm telling you, this has got to be very, very, I guess you could say, aggravating for some of these guys that is on the lead lap up here fighting for the lead. To have some of these guys that is a lap down on that strategy, it's got to be very, very aggravating to have to race them and race the guys that's on your same lap, to be honest with you. Honestly, I mean, it really pisses them off. I mean, it pissed me off. But now Meza, he's going to end up getting up into the fence. As here we go, Bradley down on the bottom. Robbie Richards, he's going to take a shot on the inside. Meza up top, trying to see if he can get up here and get his lap back with Justin White. Trying to hold on to this fourth spot is now Stephen Thomas in the 23. He's going to go down pit road.
Yeah, box, box, box is the call. First 23 got a bit wiggly there into pit road. Hopefully no spins in the pit lane for Stephen Thomas there. So Keith Bradley will inherit the lead there. But now that might set off a chain reaction throughout the rest of the front runners to pit in the next couple of laps there. Riding on board with the Dean of Deans, Dean Doucette now. Up into P4, he takes Joey Doucette, no relation, different surname spelling there between those two. See CJ Fondor there in the 40 truck. Battle for the lead now between Keith Bradley and Robert Richards, as Keith Bradley might be coming down this time. He's right to the bottom of the racetrack, doesn't elect to come down to pit road, neither does Richards or White in tow. Seven laps to go in stage number two.
And Joker Joey Doucette, he's going to go down pit road. He's got a couple of guys that may end up going right behind him. Ed Osborne's going to go. Lucas Whitehead's going to go. So a couple of guys back here are going to follow the Joker Joey Doucette, who was up at the front trying to battle it out for the lead. Keith Bradley, he's still got the lead. Raul Meza has got his lap back, so he's been able to get around all of these drivers. So now look at all of this right here. Got a couple of guys up here that don't even have a front clip on the trucks. Wow, this may end up getting very, very interesting when they end up catching them. And I believe that is Zach Hartwick in the 38. But now, Robbie Richards, he's going to take it. Here he goes. Robbie Richards going. Keith Bradley, he's going to go. Hartwick, he ain't even got a front bumper. He's going, as well as Jose Luis Rivera. Three drivers right there on the lead lap. They're making their pit stops right here. Coming to 10 laps to go. 11 to go now, but next time by, it'll be 10 to go in stage number two.
Yeah, Justin White will inherit the lead there, as it'll be 10 to go at the stripe. Stage 2 will end at lap 55. See Joe Doucette there just in front of our race leader, Justin White, in the number 2 concerns of police survivors. Number 2. But Dean Doucette, who has already pitted, has got some electric pace at the minute. The Dean of Deans, who we ride on board with now, looking to take the lead from Justin White, who I think has just elected to pit. There he goes in the number 2 truck.
Dean Doucette. How about that? Dean Doucette up here. He has got the lead, and he's got to work around the Joker, Joey Doucette. Now, Brandon Broadfoot back here. He's not made his pit stop yet. He's back here sitting in the second spot. Brian Chu, Justin White, he's still on pit road. So all these other guys is going to end up going by him very, very quickly here in a matter of moments. Dean Doucette in the 55. I know we got Dean Pickles over here. He's getting really fired up as now Dean Doucette may be looking. Here he goes. Dean Doucette in the 55. He's going to go down and get his pit stop lined up as now Brandon Broadfoot, Brian Chu, all these guys making their scheduled pit stops right here with 10 laps to go in stage two.
Yeah, we've seen some guys making their late pit stops now. Chris Blanchard will also come down into the pit lane, which means that Nathan Scott will inherit the lead. He is your current race leader with the fastest lap of the race. Currently one of the few to break into the 39.9s is the 6th of Nathan Scott, who currently leads in this current stint when he cycles back around. We're now focused on Keith Bradley and Justin White there. See Brandon Borford coming out of pit road.
Yeah, we'll see how this all ends up playing out. It's Brian Chu just now coming out of pits. Nathan Scott up there, he has not made that pit stop yet, I do not believe. But Brady LaBeouf, he has made that pit stop. So Brady LaBeouf should be in good shape to be able to get up here and find a way to get around some of these guys. As Dean Doucette, you just now see him coming off of pit road. Brandon Broadfoot, I don't even think he ended up taking tires. He's already back out there on the racetrack. So, wow, Brandon Broadfoot, actually now he's actually going back down pit road. I thought I just saw him end up going down pit road just a second ago. He may end up got busted for speeding. And Dean and, you know, well, William, that's one thing that we ended up, I guess you could say, neglecting to talk about, this pit road speed limit. Obviously, 180 miles an hour going around this place. You know, the pit road speed limit is 55 miles an hour. It's very, very hard to try to get slowed down coming off of turn four, especially when the tires are worn out. It's very, very tricky to try to get down pit road at a reasonable speed.
Yeah, absolutely. It's super hard. It's kind of an art form getting to pit road under green flag conditions. It's something that I'm personally not very good at. But Nathan Scott, who pit on lap number 35, he's up 30 positions since the drop of the green flag. He started 31st. He's now first with just 2 laps to go. Oh, sorry, no. 55 is in the stage, so it'll be 7 laps to go at the end of this stage. But Nathan Scott in control of proceedings so far.
I'll say this. I mean, Biggles over here in our ear, he's risking it for the biscuit right now in the stage number 2. And look right behind him. Brady LaBeouf is straight up eating into this lead. Brady LaBeouf trying to get up here, get him a stage win. And that number 24, Keith Bradley, not too far back from him. Justin White, he's actually right there in that battle with Keith Bradley. Robbie Richards, not too far back from this battle as well. But there he is. I mean, there you see it right there, the battle for third. Keith Bradley, obviously, way up there in the standings, basically leading everybody here in the Concerns of Police Survivors Truck Series. And Justin White trying to get a stranglehold on his season. And actually turn it around, I guess you could say. I talked to him about it on the door banging download a couple of weeks ago. And he really wants to get his season turned around on the Friday night series. And what better way to do it than right here in Fontana, California. Looks like he's going to get him some prime stage points currently sitting in that fourth spot.
Yeah, it's going to be some good stage points for what's been a decent season so far for the Concerns Police Survivor number 2. Obviously, he wants to keep improving and lock himself into that top 20 to fight for a championship in the playoffs. See Dean Doucette there up a good few positions. He's just in front of Robert Richards and Stephen Thomas. That's your fight for 6th through 8th of now. Just 5 laps to go in stage number 2. Keith Bradley and Justin White, they're occupying P3 and P4. But it's Nathan Scott still leading by about a second and a half over Bray LaBeouf.
I'm going to tell you right now, we really need to be watching that 55 of Dean Doucette. He's about a second, or he's literally a second, probably even a second and a half faster than Nathan Scott and Brady LaBeouf right now. He is hauling the mail around this two-mile racetrack here. I mean, wow, really, really moving. He put a 40.3 down that last time. Nathan Scott, what he hit was a 41.7, so there you see Dean Doucette really trying to work up here. He's going to get around Brandon Cooper. He's going to go around Justin White. He may end up going around Keith Bradley as well. Right here in the closing stages of stage number 2, or closing laps, rather, of stage number 2. Dean Doucette really getting aggressive. Bradley jumps down, cuts the nose off, but he's got no tires. He's got nowhere to go with it. Brandon Cooper in the 08. He's on the bottom now. Doucette up top, Cooper down on the bottom side. It's coming around this time. 3 laps to go here at stage number 2.
Yeah, it's 3 laps to go now. I don't know if Cooper and Doucette will quite have enough time to catch Nathan Scott. They might catch Brady LaBeouf before the end of this. As Nathan Scott now leading by almost 2 seconds. So he's really put the burner on towards the end of this stage. 2/10 of a second faster than Brady LaBeouf just this last time. But Dean Doucette put down a 40.8, 1.1 seconds faster than Brady LaBeouf in front of him. And look at Brady LaBeouf. It's like he's standing still compared to Dean Doucette on that fresh rubber there. So into second place goes Dean Doucette. He's got 2 laps to try and catch Nathan Scott. 1.8 seconds the interval at the stripe. Let's see if he can get that stage win.
I got a feeling he's going to end up taking it, honestly. I feel like Dean Doucette basically has got rocket fuel, nitrous, in that number 55 Toyota. He is really making a lot of great gains, obviously very, very fast. Obviously, pit road has been closed, folks, by the race control. So this time around, they're going to end up getting that white flag. And then we're going to see if Dean Doucette is going to be able to catch Scott. You got Brandon Cooper back here trying to fight off Brady LaBeouf. But Nathan Scott, he's going to come around this time. One more lap, and will Dean Doucette be able to catch him? He's already cut it down to less than a second at this point. 0.740. Dean Doucette trying to work some magic in that number 55 Toyota. Scott up on the top side. Scott almost ends up getting up into the fence. Dean Doucette, he's going to try to get the run. Scott trying to break the draft going down to the bottom of the racetrack. And Dean Doucette obviously got the nitrous, got the four fresh tires, the better tire than all of them. Dean Doucette sends it on the top side. Scott's going to see if he can hold it down there. Maybe end up door banging for the stage two win. Not able to do it. Stage two winner at the line is Dean Doucette in the 55. Nathan Scott will get second. Brandon Cooper will get third. Brady LaBeouf and Keith Bradley, the top five after stage number two. What a finish. Folks, I've never seen anything like that here in Nazareth, especially for a stage win. That is awesome.
Dean Doucette played that strategy to absolute perfection. Just pipped Nathan Scott at the line with a lightning fast last lap, 40.99 compared to a 41.78 for Nathan Scott, and just got him by a couple hundredths of a second there at the line. So he absolutely flew through the field after putting on that 46. He had just 10 laps to make up that gap, and he did it just in the nick of time. So stage two winning some valuable points there for the Dean of Deans, Dean Doucette.
Wow, how about that double D? Dean Doucette ends up getting it. Wow, I'm telling you, folks, that was a straight up charge right there that the Canadian Dean Doucette ended up making right there to get that stage two win. A couple of guys back here, 6th through 10th, that will end up receiving stage points. Justin White, Robbie Richards, Stephen Thomas, Chris Cinnamon, and Eric Zimmerman will end up finishing stage number two in 10th. Folks, we're going to take a quick commercial break. Let these guys go ahead, get down pit road. When they end up coming back from pit road, we'll come back and we'll grab Dean Doucette with a word from him. Don't go anywhere. Folks, we're back here at Auto Club Fontana, however you want to look at it, right here in California. Folks, I'm telling you right now, you saw a fantastic finish right there. Stage number two, we'll see who ends up beating who out of the pits. Looks like it may end up being Dean Doucette, unless some of these other guys up at the front can try to beat him out. It doesn't look like they're going to end up doing it. How about Brandon Cooper? He's going to end up getting pretty good little jump right here up through the field, so he'll end up coming out second. Right behind him is going to be Nathan Scott in the six. And Brady LaBeouf going to come out fourth. Justin White fifth. Keith Bradley will come out sixth. Right behind him is Robbie Richards. But, folks, we're going to go in here and see if we can find Mr. Dean Doucette through all of these chats. Got a feeling we'll end up finding him sooner rather than later. Folks, you have to give me 1 second. And maybe we'll find Dean Doucette here in a second. But, I mean, William, I mean, what did you think about that finish? I mean, because it was a crazy, crazy finish all the way down to the end.
That was awesome. I mean, it's definitely a nail biter. But I think when you just saw the pace difference, once Dean Doucette had that clean air and he just had Nathan Scott in front of him, I mean, you saw in the battle box in the bottom right, the interval, especially through the corners, going down and down and down. Like, every single, like, frame was another tenth into that interval. It was just gone. In that battle box, he was down to half a second before we knew it. And then he just played it to perfection. He managed to take the air off the six, didn't let him get the run. The 55 used that momentum from the high side, just blast past the six, right at the line, and pip him by a couple hundredths to take an all-valuable stage win, which, considering the playoff picture, is going to be instrumental to Dean Doucette trying to make that top 20.
Absolutely, and I'm looking right now. I'm trying to find Dean Doucette. I'm not able to find him in any of the chats. So apparently he's trying to put the block, I guess you could say, on the Nazareth 360 Racing Network. Shout out to you, every single one of you out there in the live chat. Let us know who you think is going to end up winning this race. Obviously, stages, they are done. Stages is done here tonight. And, you know, any of you viewers out there, you know, give us a shout out. You know, if you've watched any of the races from this past week with the Nazareth 360 Racing Network, what was your favorite race? Want to hear from you out there, the fans. What was your favorite race? Was it the DSR Electric Truck Series, which was at North Wilkesboro? Was it the Cruising Classics Next Gen Series for Goat Locker, which was at Indy on Wednesday night? Or was it last night with the ARCA Series, the Veterans for Life ARCA Series, at Darlington? Let us know out there in the comments, what was your favorite race? And we may end up giving you our picks. Me and Dean Biggles may end up talking about that after the race and give you our picks. Or maybe, hell, who knows, it could end up being this race here tonight as Barney the Flagman. He's got that flag in the air. Dean Doucette, Brandon Cooper, they're going to lead him to the green flag. And here we go. Final stage here at Auto Club for the Butt Kicker 200. Dean Doucette, he's going to get a fantastic jump. Cooper up on the top side. Basically a roadblock right now for Brady LaBeouf. And Nathan Scott down on the bottom. Brady LaBeouf made a very evasive move from the middle. Looked like he got loose. Tried to jump down. Now he's going to battle with Cooper for third.
He has a super solid start there from Dean Doucette, stage two winner. But the guy who he just took it from by a couple hundredths, Nathan Scott, absolutely wasting no time in getting to the lead. Big send from Nathan Scott. Dean Doucette doesn't see the need to fight at the minute. And Brady LaBeouf's going to get into second as well. But Dean Doucette tries to get to the inside. LaBeouf throws the block, goes right down to the apron, trying to follow the slipstream of the number six, Nathan Scott, that is. And Dean Doucette up on the high side, down to third for the time being. But we'll have to see where he is in 40 laps time to be the real judge of that move.
See what he does. Obviously slides up just a little bit. Here comes the animal, Keith Bradley in the 29, down on the bottom side. Jumps up, gets right in front of Cooper. Thomas on Scoob back there. He's going to take a shot. We got a caution on the Speedway. Must have been way back there in the back. Caution on the Speedway, and I'm looking to see exactly where it was at. We're hearing it was Casey Meek in the 69. Yes, it was. He ends up getting turned around coming off of turn number two. We'll end up seeing what happened to Mr. Mink as they worked their way through three and four right here. And may ended up being a little bit of contact with the 60. Jeff Merck, no, it was not. He ended up just sliding up. Hope Wigginton, Christopher Blanchard will end up getting involved. You're checking out right here on the instant replay.
It's coming into turn one here. 69 to Casey Menke. As he is four wide, you see, he's got the 60, the double zero, the nine on top of him. He just gets loose, slides up, hits the zero, hits the nine. A couple cars involved in that one, a massive impact there into the inside wall for the 69 of Casey Menke. That's probably meatball territory there for Menke. Super unfortunate there for that particular driver. His day might be done as he's in pit lane now.
Yeah, and I'm probably going to end up catching a little bit of beef probably from Miss Dawn out there, probably since I called out Jeff, and then Jeff had nowhere, he was close to it, but he had no partake in any of what happened. We're going to see if some of these guys may end up taking a shot. And, you know, William, we've seen this right here. Me and Dean, we've talked about some of them guys doing what they're doing going into the pits. Obviously, Joey Doucette, he is going to make that stop. Chris Cinnamon's going to end up making that stop, but I want to get your take on this right here, William, because, you know, we see guys go into the pits or act like they're going to go and then dart out. What's your take on that? Because I hear a lot of leagues say, oh, no, you can't do that. That's outlawed. I think it's perfectly fine to do it. What's your take on guys doing that?
Oh, I'd absolutely agree. I think it's, you know, it's another element of gamesmanship. You know, it's a dummy like any other. You know, you're fake to the inside, you're fake to the outside. It's the same thing. You're fake to pit road. It's, you know, I think, you know, when you run right up to the barrels and then someone follows you and they hit the barrels, that's kind of skirting the final. But it's, if it's an innocent dart in and out, then you know that's just gamesmanship, and I think that's a part of the game, part of motor racing. So I think it's perfectly cool.
Yeah, I mean, I agree 100%. I mean, you know, as long as it doesn't involve getting somebody tore up, I guess you could say, you know, I agree 100%. You know, it needs to be just fine, I guess you could say, and let everybody go ahead, do what they got to do until somebody ends up getting screwed in it. And if they don't end up getting screwed, then guess what? They'll be in good shape. Folks, we're going to go ahead and take a quick commercial break. Let you hear from a great, great setup shop. Here in this ad, don't go anywhere. Check this out.
Storebase 1552 Comics. We sell everything a collector would want. Comics, Funkos, action figures, and so many more. A real American comic book shop. We are online only. Storebase 1552 Comics. Find us on eBay Auctions.
Folks, we're back here at Auto Club, and obviously we love every single one of our sponsors, and one of those sponsors that you saw right there in those ads, Premier Racing Setups. As I've said numerous times on the door banging download in that ad, you need a Premier Racing Setup, go check them out, PremierRacingSetups.com. When you get over there, you get everything lined up, get it all in your little shopping cart online. Go ahead and make sure you enter in that code of NASRA, N-A-S-R-A. When you do that, you will get 15% off your entire order. And then also, if that 15% will get kicked back to the North America Sim Racing Association. And as I've said numerous times here on the broadcast, if you want to race the setups that the Redneck Announcer and the Mountain Man, Robert Hill Jr. races, go check them out. PremierRacingSetups.com. We're going to see if any of these guys can be really premier here tonight at Fontana. Green flag in the air. Nathan Scott in the number six. He has the lead. He's going to get a good jump. He's going to try to jump up in front of Keith Bradley and Brady LaBeouf. Keith Bradley trying to give the shove to LaBeouf. Now LaBeouf going to stay up top. Bradley going down to the bottom side. Dean Doucette, he's back here. He's at a Hornet's Nest. He's got Thomas. He's got Cooper. He's got all of them coming off a two.
Yellow.
Caution on the speedway.
Must have been further back there, maybe caused by the stack up there. Just trying to see who's involved. Must have been further
CJ
in the back.
CJ Fondale.
Try and catch a replay.
It's the 40 as CJ Fondale ends up going around. We'll see exactly what happened to the 40 of Fondale. Looked like he actually got tagged in the back end and then ended up going down the racetrack. Somebody else ended up tagging him. We'll check it out right here on the instant replay. Fondale back there in the number 40. Obviously, got a very, very special paint scheme on that number 40. We'll talk about that here in just a second after we see the replay of everything that happened right here. But you'll see it right here. It's a little bit of a stack up. We got Cody Nod up at the front. They're looking four wide.
Ooh.
Fondale gets out of the gas. Broadfoot ends up getting into him. And then Fondale ends up going down the racetrack, ends up getting into Morton, and it ends up having a caution on the speedway. But, folks, I do want to talk about that paint scheme here for just a little bit, because C.J. Fondale, the number 40, he has got that paint scheme. COPS, the Concerns of Police Survivors, they absolutely love this scheme that Fondale's running, so that's why he's running it out here tonight. And, they also highlight COPS Shop Store that COPS has to raise funds for the events that they put on. So go out there and check it out, copsshop.org. That is the website if you want to go over there and check that out. It's CJ Fondale, the COPS Shop Truck. Say that one three times for you folks. The number 40 ends up going down. A lot of guys end up going down P pit road. You see, a bunch of them right here. Brandon Broadfoot obviously ended up getting involved. Then you see Jeff Merck going down as well. Lucas Whitehead, Hutt Wigginton. A lot of drivers going down pit road after this early caution right here coming off of turn two.
Yeah, it seemed to be caused by just a little bit of a stack up there. Saw the 26 get a little bit loose there. It was a little offset four wide there for the middle of turns one and two. I think CJ Fondo just reacted to it. He tries to, kind of preemptively avoid it, and he just gets tagged in the back. Involves a couple other guys like Brandon Broadfoot there. So that is our fifth caution of the evening, including our stage breaks. But Nathan Scott, after a good start, retains the lead.
Absolutely, and we may end up trying to see if we can maybe bring a driver in. I was actually trying to look for Nathan Scott, but I cannot find him. So I tell you what, we'll go ahead. We'll bring the boss man up here. He's running into second spot. Go ahead and bring up the boss man, Brady LaBeouf. And Brady, looking pretty good up there in that number 24. Obviously started ninth. You worked your way up here to second right behind Nathan Scott. How's the truck feeling out there?
Oh, it feels great, Jacob. I'm just kind of really buying my time. But these cautions are really, really kind of changing up the strategy of this race. We all know that we got to make, a pit stop here in this final stage. You can go about 22 laps on a fuel run. So just kind of, looking to see what lap we want to go on, but really need this race to go green.
Absolutely. And, for some of the folks out there, if you remember back to last season for the DSR Electric Truck Series, Brady LaBeouf, obviously the defending champion for the Monday Night Series, he won here at Auto Club and got that win and got himself that championship. So, Brady, you're trying to use a little bit, I guess you could say maybe a little strategy of what you had going on for the Monday Night to try to win the championship last season.
Yeah, Auto Club's got a special place in my heart. The first win I ever got on iRacing whenever I joined was at Auto Club. And then I won the championship, like you just said, last season on Mondays. And I actually have a win here on Fridays. I believe it was season five. I beat Stephen Thomas here. So I love this place, but I can tell you this, it's not driving the same way it did on Mondays. It's a lot different. So we got a work kind cut out for us, but we're going to, give them hell.
We'll see what happens. Brady LaBeouf in the number 24. Appreciate your time and good luck, buddy.
Thank you. Appreciate you guys.
That was Brady LaBeouf. He's going to start on the outside of the front row. Nathan Scott is going to elect to take the bottom. Pace slides is out. Keith Bradley going to be in that second row with Dean Doucette. We'll try to run through the top 10 real quick. Stephen Thomas, Brandon Cooper, Brian Chuse, Justin White, Jose Luis Rivera, and Robbie Richards. The biggest mover so far in that field is Brandon Cooper and Nathan Scott, both of them up 30 spots. Green flag in the air. Nathan Scott's going to get a fantastic jump. And Keith Bradley, he's going to take it down to the bottom side. Brady LaBeouf up on the top side. Thomas going to see if he can stick it in there on the inside. He's going to be able to make it work. Gets up to Brady's door. He may end up getting to Bradley's door as they come off of turn two.
Yeah, it didn't look to be an ideal getaway for Brady LaBeouf, really anyone on the outside line. But Stephen Thomas got a brilliant run there, managed to get to the inside there of Brady. Looked to the inside there of the animal, Keith Bradley. He does so again with 3 wide for second place. Brady LaBeouf working the very high side, and he's going to have the run. He's conserved some decent momentum there on the outside of the 29 there, but he does not look to force the issue through the middle of 3 wide. So he chooses instead to push the 29 clear into second place. And now LaBeouf and Thomas, who Brady mentioned, they were battling back in season five for the win here in Fontana, California. They're now back fighting for third here. But in front of them on board with Brady LaBeouf, it's Keith Bradley and Nathan Scott, as Brady gets super loose. Might have got tagged there on his left rear there by Stephen Thomas, or maybe a shot in the back there from Brian Chu, who's made some decent progress on this restart. Brian Chu, they're up in sixth now. Dean Doucette clears the pair of them. Big power move there by the 55. He's up to fourth temporarily, but Stephen Thomas now looking to battle back there in that position.
Yeah, that was a little bit of door banging. We get some action back in the back. Back there around the back. No caution on the speedway. It was Phil Pappas, Brandon Bullock, both of them back there. They will be able to continue. It was getting crazy back there in the back. It's getting crazy up front. Now Thomas, he's going to be able to get up here. Bradley actually took the lead. Now Scott going to take a shot on the inside. And Brady LaBeouf trying to see if he can keep the door banging out of that number 24. He got into it with Stephen Thomas the lap before. Now Bradley trying to see if he can run. He's going to jump up, get across the nose. Here comes Dean Doucette in the 55. He's down on the bottom. Thomas up top. Look at this gaggle of trucks back here going across the start-finish line. As Brady LaBeouf, he's going to take a shot. They're going three wide for the lead. Scott stuck up on the top side. He may end up getting the run coming off the corner, but now Bradley going to try to pull the slide job off of two.
Yeah, Keith Bradley pulled that awesome move there. Stephen Thomas nicks the wall there off of turn two. You saw Keith Bradley pull that awesome move a lap ago to get past Nathan Scott, but kind of kills momentum as Nathan Scott now tries to retaliate a lap later after Keith Bradley pulls a similar move, and he does get in front now. But Keith Bradley will try and pull the crossover. He has the better run coming off of turn four. See if Brady LaBeouf can get in on the action. See if we go three wide again for the lead for the second lap in a row. But Keith Bradley, Nathan Scott, some of the biggest movers of this race, now side by side for the lead. But we're now going to ride on board with Brady LaBeouf as Keith Bradley does take the lead there. Stephen Thomas just behind there in P4. Nathan Scott might have to settle for P2 for the time being. He's now on board with Stephen Thomas. LaBeouf does think about trying to split that gap, thinks better of it. Stephen Thomas now to the outside of LaBeouf, looking for third behind them. Dean Doucette, Brian Chu, and Jose Luis Severo, winner of the All-Star race at Atlanta a few weeks ago. Now three wide for fourth.
Yeah, Rivera stuck in the middle. Brian Chu trying to see if he can jump up there, maybe get in behind him. He is hung out to dry. Robbie Richards, he's got his own problems right behind him with Brandon Cooper in the 08. He's going to be able to try to make that block. Now Cooper, he's going to take a shot. He's going to go down to the bottom. Nathan Scott way up there on the top side. He may end up getting the run and getting to the right rear. Keith Bradley, and he'll do it. Nathan Scott, where did this guy come from? 31st all the way up to the lead. Nathan Scott trying to battle with the animal, Keith Bradley, but now they got company. Thomas right behind him. Bradley going to ease up here. He's going to go to second. Scott's going to get slipped back as Brady LaBeouf almost ends up getting into it with Thomas. Folks, I'm telling you right now, that's maybe the third time right there that Brady LaBeouf and Thomas have made just a little bit of contact as Keith Bradley has the lead going into one.
Riding on board now with Jose Luis Rivera, as I mentioned. Won the All-Star race at Atlanta, knows how to win on these big tracks in the Cup Truck Series. As he slides to the inside there of Stephen Thomas, incisive move there from Rivera. He's now behind the boss man, Brady LaBeouf there. We look to drivers outside. We now look on the deck lid of the number 20. You see the leaders out in front. Keith Bradley leading the pack. He's got Nathan Scott behind him in hot pursuit. That's LaBeouf and Thomas fighting for third. Thomas chooses to go single file for the time being. Jose Luis Rivera on the inside there. In P5, a single file there. Someone in the back, Brian Chu, in the grass on the front straightaway, 25 to go.
Yeah, you hate to say that for Brian Chu. He was up there running inside the top 10. We stay with this battle up here. Keith Bradley really running up on this top side, trying to get the momentum. Usually that's where we're seeing a lot of the passes here at Auto Club. Obviously, you're able to get that fantastic run off the top side and be able to take it all the way to the front. And that's exactly what Bradley was able to do. Now Brady LaBeouf, he's going to try to follow his old teammate right here with Keith Bradley and try to get up to second. And that's exactly where he's going to go. So Scott, he's going to get pumped back to third. Thomas up here with Rivera. That's the top five with Robbie Richards, Justin White, Brandon Cooper, Eric Zimmerman, and Joshua Rodriguez. We need to watch this guy back here in the 32. He's made some very, very crazy gains to be able to get himself up here. Obviously started 33rd. Now he's up to 10th. So this is a crazy top 10 that you see before you right here, folks.
Pretty much everyone in the top 10 has gained at least one spot from the start. Not to mention Josh Rodriguez, who's made up 23 spots, started 33rd, now is in 10th behind these nine trucks in front of him. Zimmerman, Cooper, White, Richards immediately in front of him. Jose Luis Rivera as well in that gaggle. He's got Robbie Richards on his inside, further in front of them. Nathan Scott's on the inside of Stephen Thomas, and Brady LaBeouf now got trying to retaliate after losing the lead to Bradley and LaBeouf earlier on. But now Thomas will have the run, and he's going to be just immediately behind LaBeouf there. So Scott not able to split the hole there. Scott will drop down to fourth behind Stephen Thomas. Scott maybe just preserving himself for the time being as Robbie Richards moves to the inside, trying to take fourth there. In that 48, Justin White gets past Jose Luis Rivera, who drops a couple spots there on that particular lap, but now 22 laps to go and they get to the stripe, and it's the animal Keith Bradley controlling the pace.
22 laps to go here in the ButtKicker 200, and not too back, not too far back, obviously, right here in front of Craig Schroeder. We'll talk about him in just a second. Eric Zimmerman, he's up on the top side. They were three wide for a second with Dean Doucette on the bottom. Rodriguez, now we may see some more three wide. Yes, we will. Rodriguez down on the bottom. Zimmerman, he's going to try to get the run. Dean Doucette stuck in the middle. And check out right behind him, Craig Schroeder. Folks, you remember him. He started on the pole here for the ButtKicker 200. Got spun out earlier on. He has made a hell of a climb to get back up here and maybe get up here and have a shot to battle for the top 10. As we see some guys up here, Jose Luis Rivera, Chris Sediment, all these guys going down pit road right now.
Yeah, that's near the front of the pack now as Keith Bradley and Nathan Scott dive by Stacey Thomas of Richards now, who's made up a couple spots. Justin White as well. Brady LaBeouf has lost a few positions. He's down to sixth as Justin White gives a shot to Stephen Thomas trying to get that 23 truck moving and see if the stop from a couple of those guys a little further behind sets off a chain reaction further in front here. As we have just 20 laps to go, these guys will have to make another pit stop, and it's Nathan Scott. See Justin White and Brady LaBeouf making pit stops there, but Nathan Scott, Keith Bradley still door-to-door, side-by-side for the lead. 20 laps to go at the stripe.
Woo! May end up seeing a little bit of door banging right here as close as these guys are getting Bradley and Scott up here. Bradley trying to force him down, almost ends up turning him, going into turn one. Scott going to slide up in front of Keith Bradley at the side-by-side battle. The race is on. Robbie Richards, Stephen Thomas trying to go for third. Brandon Cooper up here as well. As William White mentioned just a second ago, a lot of guys going down pit road. We may end up seeing a couple of them right here. Keith Bradley, Robbie Richards, now they're going to go down pit road. Keith Bradley, Robbie Richards. Richards Ooh. Tried to outbreak him, and Zimmerman gets spun back in the back.
He hit Craig Schroeder. He got sent to the grass there, so I think he might have missed pit lane. I think he's going to have to go around again. He's not going to be able to reverse, so he's going to have to go around again. He's going to lose a bundle of time. Pole sitter Craig Schroeder there, involved in a very unfortunate incident.
Nathan Scott, he's up here. We'll see when he ends up going down pit road. There you see Jose Luis Rivera trying to slice and dice through the pack. Check out the speed right here, folks. This is what you get when you get fresher tires up against worn-out tires. Rivera just basically goes wherever he wants to go. Little door banging right here in front of him with Dean Doucette and Brandon Broadfoot. Rivera, he is rolling. Stephen Thomas, now he's going down pit road. We may end up seeing five wide here at Auto Club, but Justin White wasn't able to get there. He gets out of the gas, so it was four wide there for just a split second. Rivera, he's going to end up getting out of all that. And now Brady LaBeouf's going to try to get up here.
Yeah, he's three wide. Might be offset four wide as they work past Robert Richards, who's just coming off of the pit road. I think we had offset five wide down the front straight for a split second. These lot are absolutely mental to see in any gap that they can go. It's three wide again. Justin White splits the middle. Chris Sinema now splitting the middle as Josh Rodriguez will take to the pit lane. We're riding on board with the Joker, Joey Doucette, just behind Robert Richards. 17 laps to go in the ButtKicker 200 here in Fontana, California, as the 16 of Joey Doucette rides in P5, just behind Robert Richards, who is a lap down as a result of the current pit cycle. These guys still yet to pit, as we see Stephen Thomas now coming out the pit lane.
Yep, there you see Stephen Thomas actually getting all everything lined up, folks. I'm telling you, I'm tickled to death that I'm not racing in this one. I'm happy that I ended up coming up here in the broadcast booth, because I would have already went crazy at some of this racing that's been going on here tonight. Brady LaBeouf, he is actually going to unlap himself from Nathan Scott right now. That's how fast the pace is already picked up. And now Brady LaBeouf, he's trying to run down Jose Luis Rivera right in front of him. You see these other guys, they may end up trying to go just maybe a little bit longer to be able to maybe have a little bit more fresher tires than some of these guys that's up here at the front, which will be at the front once everything cycles out. Should end up being Jose Luis Rivera, Brady LaBeouf, and Justin White. Those guys should be the ones that will be the lead once the rest of the field ends up cycling out.
Yeah, the first guys to pit will reap the benefits of the undercut, as you see. Fresh tire, having a little bit of a scrap there. It's Brady LaBeouf and Jose Luis Rivera having a fight for what is currently P11 on the racetrack, but that's going to cycle through as Nathan Scott does take to pit road. his seat. Brandon Cooper, Dean Doucette, Joey Doucette as well come in to the pit lane. Adam Newton there in the 19. So the lead is now pitting. So the guys like Brady Leboeuf will benefit from the undercut strategy that should put them close to the lead, if not in position number one. They see Rivera and White just behind him in positions two and three, effectively, on the racetrack, as they're going to come to 15, maybe 14 laps to go when they hit the stripe. So we'll have to wait and see. Lucas Whitehead, your current leader. Brandon Broadfoot, Chris Blanchard as well. Lucas Whitehead elects to stay out for the time being, so it'll be 14 laps to go when Whitehead hits the stripe, so not a lot of time left for moves to be made by these front runners. But now these guys that start to come in now, Morton coming in, but the guys just coming out, the likes of Nathan Scott, will start to benefit from having much fresher times. We'll see if those guys can battle back and fight for the lead at the end of this thing.
We'll see what happens. It's getting very, very aggressive up here. Some guys starting to make some crazy moves. There you see Rodriguez back here trying to take him a shot at CJ Fondale. These guys trying to get up here, get around Whitehead, be able to get the beneficiary of trying not to end up getting stuck a lap down. That's one thing you really don't want to end up seeing, is you see Brandon Broadfoot, he's going to go in. Whitehead, he's still on the racetrack because he's got these other guys coming through with fresh tires. Fondale trying to get through. Rodriguez trying to get through. It's Whitehead way up the racetrack, trying to run as long as he can. There you see Brady Leboeuf. He's already worked his way up to fifth. He's got Rivera, White, Sentiment, and Thomas, all of them right behind him. But so far, it looks like the boss man end up getting, or he may end up getting the win should something not end up happening right here, because Whitehead's going to have to pit. Blanchard and Morton, they've already pit. We'll see how this all plays out. Obviously, now 13 laps to go here at Auto Club.
Yeah, Lucas Whitehead still staying out, trying to run as long as he can. He saw Broadfoot and Blanchard come in behind him. So Lucas Whitehead, the only one yet to pit so far in this particular pit sign. You can see Rivera and White fighting for effective second place on the racetrack. You see the Spiceman Chris Inman, who we're riding on board with now, trying to join the fray. If we're not counting Lucas Whitehead, who's currently up in the race lead on track, P3, P4, P5, effectively second, third, and fourth on the racetrack. Brady Leboeuf will inherit the lead when Lucas Whitehead takes the pit road. So there could be big implications for this. But guys like Nathan Scott, I'm keeping a close eye on them. The gap between Brady Leboeuf and Nathan Scott is 4.5 seconds. And we know the pace differential on fresh tires. Don't look now, but Nathan Scott might be flying towards the lead before long.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. Obviously, Nathan Scott made that pit stop. He is not too far back, I guess you could say, from the leaders. Everybody pretty much cycling back out. So Brady Leboeuf will end up inheriting the lead once they end up getting around Lucas Whitehead. Whitehead just now end up getting out of his pit box. And Sentiment really is trying to spice it up here with Justin White. He's going to take it up on the top side. White tries to go all the way down to the apron. So does Jose Luis Rivera. Sentiment not able to make the pass, but he is trying his damnedest up here on this top side. He's trying all he can do. It's now Justin White. He's going to try to send it, maybe try to pull the slider, jump up right in front of him. He's going to be able to do it, but guess what? Since Lucas Whitehead went down pit road, your new leader, Brady Leboeuf, he leads here at Auto Club, coming this time around, 10 laps to go.
He has 0.8 of a second on All-Star winner Jose Luis Rivera. So a past Truck Series champion leads the way. Obviously, Chris Sinnemann and Justin White racing hard for that final podium position. They make gains just a little bit on Jose Luis Rivera there. Still side by side though. Sinnemann on the inside, Justin White on the outside. Chris Sinnemann giving Justin White as little room as possible, and Sentiment is into third place ahead of Justin White.
Sentiment really being very, very aggressive. Like I said, he was trying to spice it up with Justin White. He was able to do it. Brady Leboeuf, he's really trying to check out from the rest of the field as Rivera. He may be in a little bit of trouble now, as Sentiment now may end up taking a shot at him. And obviously, he was very, very aggressive with Justin White. So he may end up being very, very aggressive with Jose Luis Rivera here in just a little bit. You see him, everybody trying to get what draft they can get. Justin White trying to end up getting the draft. And now Thomas back up here. Old Scoob, Stephen Thomas up here, sitting in the fifth spot. He's going to try to go for fourth. J. Justin White down on the bottom. Stephen Thomas ends up getting up here. We may end up seeing three wide if the hole will present itself, with Stephen Thomas trying to get very aggressive up here with a Spice Man and Justin White, and he will end up making that shot. He's going to go right down to the bottom side. Stephen Thomas trying to go for third on the Spice Man.
And Stephen Thomas really capitalizing on his fresher tires there. He pitted on lap 82, a couple laps after Cinnamon and White, so he has got slightly fresher rubber. Cinnamon just trying to push Stephen Thomas, trying to make them both go a little bit faster, but Stephen Thomas now up into a podium position. His tires are fresher than that of Rivera and LaBeouf in front of him. He's trying to move to the inside of Jose Luis Rivera for second place. Stephen Thomas makes some big moves, but look who that is. That's Nathan Scott flying through. He's already up into fifth place. He pitted on lap 85. He's much fresher than everyone in front of him, and look at the grip he has. Blows by Justin White. He's going to be on the inside of Rivera before long. He's already looking for third. Stephen Thomas takes second. Nathan Scott trying to get third from Jose Luis Rivera as they come down the front straight. But Brady LaBeouf has a gap of just over a second from the guys behind him.
Here comes Justin White, though. Justin White, do not count out that number two. C.O.P.S. Toyota Tundra back there in the back, trying to get up here, give these guys a little bit of a fit. But Nathan Scott has gotten around Stephen Thomas. So Nathan Scott, you talked about it, William. Don't look now. That's six. He may end up giving Brady LaBeouf some fits, because Scott has really been putting down some fast, fast lap times compared to Brady LaBeouf. About a half a second faster a lap right now. There you see Scott coming off of turn four. He's got Thomas right behind him. He's got Justin White right behind him. We see the first side-by-side battle inside the top five with Jose Luis Rivera on the top side. Robbie Richards down on the bottom side. Richards trying to get around Rivera. Rivera may end up burning his stuff up as he goes way up to the top of the racetrack just where Scott was. Scott damn near ended up cleaning the fence out right there coming off of turn two, but he's able to try to keep it straight. He's starting to put them laps down. Brady LaBeouf better watch in his mirror, because here comes the number six of Nathan Scott.
Yeah, Nathan Scott half a second quicker last time around. It is six laps to go, it'll be five to go when they get to the gap sinking all the time there between LaBeouf and Scott. But further back, see Lucas Whitehead and Devin Painter going for it for 13th. That's Doucette and Mesa just in front of him. So playoff implications here as Mesa blinks a little. He's back now as that's Whitehead moving to the inside of Joey Doucette. They almost touch going into turn one. Lucas Whitehead, power move on Lucas Whitehead and Joey Doucette there. But you see, for the lead now, Nathan Scott and Brady LaBeouf fighting for the lead. Five laps to go before when they get to the stripe. Brady LaBeouf can't do anything. He's on five lap older tyres. Nathan Scott has all the grip in the world, and he takes the lead. It's four laps to go out the stripe. Nathan Scott, new leader.
Nathan Scott with the power move around the boss man, Brady LaBeouf. Brady tried to put the block on him over in turn one and two. He wasn't able to do it. Nathan Scott, he has got the lead, but Brady LaBeouf wants it back. There you see Scott trying to run the top side, carry the momentum. Brady about a lane down from where Scott is running, not trying to get too aggressive, not trying to get up there and actually try to throw it away. He may end up wanting to see if Scott may end up throwing away. But that number six has just been bad fast, really, all night long. Started, didn't even qualify, folks. He did not even put down a qualifying time. We didn't even have him in our picks at this point. As you're actually going to see a little bit more battling back here. Team Doucette, he's stuck in the middle. Keith Bradley, they door bang. They door bang coming to the line. Dean Doucette, he is in the middle now. He's going to be on the low side. Bradley trying to give the side draft to him. Still door banging going into one as Cooper was able to get around that whole mess. And we may end up seeing a little bit more battling up here with some guys up here. Jose Luis Rivera and Robbie Richards, now they're battling for the fifth spot.
Yeah, sixth place Rivera. But see, Stephen Thomas there also on fresher tires than Brady LaBeouf there, pitted two laps later than Brady here as he rode on board with the 23s coming out of turn four. He allowed the slipstream this time by Brady trying to break the draft. He takes to below the apron. Thomas follows him down, two laps to go, limited time. Nathan Scott pulling out clear in the lead. It's his race to lose, but here comes Stephen Thomas right to the back of the number 24 Chevrolet. That's Brady LaBeouf, the boss man, in second place. A past series champion knows how to win here. Might not take the checkered flag, But he's got Stephen Thomas and Justin White just behind him. He's going to have to use all his experience to try and hold those guys off. As Stephen Thomas, Justin White, and now Robbie Richards have joined the fray and are going to be applying the pressure big time.
Four-way battle for the second spot as they are coming to the white flag. Nathan Scott is straight up checked out, but we'll get to him in just a second. We're going to see how this ends up playing out with these four drivers right here, Bray LaBeouf, Thomas, Justin White, and Robbie Richards trying to battle it out for that second spot. Brady LaBeouf up on the top side. Thomas is going to go by him. They may end up looking three wide, but Justin White able to get around Richards. Richards goes way up the racetrack, almost ends up tagging the fence, and White trying to get up here, get that podium finish. But here we go, going into three. Nathan Scott in the number six. Bray LaBeouf taking one more shot at Stephen Thomas. He's not going to be able to do it, but Nathan Scott in the number six. We didn't even have him picked in our pool. He's going to get the win here tonight at Fontana for the ButtKicker 200 for the Concerns of Police Survivors Truck Series. Nathan Scott, your winner. Stephen Thomas will get second. Brady LaBeouf will get third. He will be able to hold off Justin White for that third spot. Justin White will get fourth. Robbie Richards will end up finishing fifth. The rest of the top ten, Brandon Cooper sixth. Lucas Whitehead seventh. Dean Doucette will finish eighth. Chris Cinnamon will get ninth. And Jose Luis Rivera able to hold off the animal Keith Bradley for P10. Wow, what a finish here tonight. There you see the results. Nathan Scott just mentioned it for the whole top 10. Pretty much we'll go all the way down to P11 where Keith Bradley is. He ends up finishing 11th. The Joker, Joey Doucette, start on the outside of the front row. He's going to finish 12th. How about Joshua Rodriguez in that number 32? Started 33rd up to 13th. Good drive for the number 32 here tonight at Fontana. Raul Meza will end up finishing 14th. Devin Painter will get 15th. Give Brandon Broadfoot to 16th. Cody Knott to 17th. CJ Fondale, 18th, Ed Osborne, 19th, and Adam Newton rounds out the top 20 to you, William.
Yeah, we saw Huck Wigginson in 21st, Eric Zimmerman 22nd, Mark Morton there in the Hershey's number 8 is 23rd, Chris Blanchard there in the 9, 24th, Phil Pampas, Brandon Bullock, Craig Schroeder, the pulse rounds out everyone who finished on the lead lap there, so that's everyone down to 27th. Brian Chu ran into some trouble. He was the first car one lap down in P28. We see just in the background there, Nathan Scott, your winner, doing his burnouts. Rest of the classified finishes, Tyler Daniels there in the 95 and Zach Hartwick in the 38 rounds out the top 30. And the guys who unfortunately didn't see the checkered flag, Casey Menke, Jeff Merck, Jason Morales, Tyler Dittmer, Matthew Wood, and Mike Moultrie.
There you see Nathan Scott doing the burnout right here with the AAA right here at Auto Club Speedway, burning it down. There you see him. He's going through the grass trying to get everything lined up, maybe end up getting out there. There he goes, finally going to burn it down right there where the AAA is here at Auto Club Speedway. And he just keeps on spinning around all the way around, obviously giving them donuts, them fresh donuts out here at Auto Club on the West Coast. I mean, that was an absolute whale of a finish here tonight at Auto Club, folks. We'll take a quick commercial break. We'll be right back with our podium finishers. Do not go anywhere. Folks, we're back here at Auto Club Speedway for the NRE Power post-race interviews. We're going to kind of flip it here tonight, go from third all the way to first. Going to bring in the third place finisher tonight, the number 24 of Brady LaBeouf. And Brady, there for a second, buddy, I thought you actually had this sucker in the bag. But, I mean, what more could you have done to try to hold off Stephen Thomas and Nathan Scott?
Oh, well, I gave up second place because when Nathan got in front of me right there, my truck got so tight in three and four, I had the steering wheel turned 90 degrees left and it wouldn't turn. So I wish I would have gotten out the throttle a little bit more right there, and I probably would have been able to kind of stay in second, kind of stay, you know, a little bit closer to Nathan to keep the draft. But I just messed up three and four right whenever he passed me, and that's what cost me a spot. I knew what situation I was in. Me and Keith got into the wall or something, and I had to get out the throttle, so I was committed to pitting right there whenever I fell back to six. I kind of wanted to pit before all those guys, but then Justin White pitted with me too. But that was the right strategy. I just didn't work out for me.
And obviously, Brady, I mean, this track obviously going through a reconfiguration, trying to go to a short track. You talked about this earlier with this track having, I guess you could say, a near and dear place to your heart with all the success that you've had here at Auto Club. I know we'll go ahead and just ask it to you like this. Are you sad to see Auto Club go the way that it is and go to a short track, or are you anticipating and waiting for it to come to a short track?
I mean, it is what it is, right? You know, you got to evolve with the sport. You know, people sometimes don't like change, but a lot of times change is for the better. I've had to personally learn that in my life. So, I mean, it sucks that it's gone because, I mean, there's not too many tracks out there like Auto Club. I think the fans were really enjoying the racing and the product that it was putting on there for a while. I mean, I enjoy it. It seems like I run top five here every time we come here. So I guess I'm biased towards liking the track. But we'll just have to wait and see what kind of, you know, short track. I'm hearing different rumors about it. We'll just have to wait and see what kind of racing it puts on.
Well, Brady LaBeouf ends up getting third here tonight. And Brady, before we let you go, you got anybody that you want to thank that made this possible?
Yeah, first and foremost, my wife and kids. They're at a little family get together right now, and she gave me the pass to come out and race tonight. So shout out to her for holding down the house all the time and taking care of the kids and whatnot, so I can be able to do all this. Thank you to you guys, you know, broadcasting. William's new to the team, so thank you for him to come out and fill in for Robert. Thank you, Jacob, Dean, always, you know, top notch producing. Everybody at Nazareth, man, that helps. Mission One Esports, I know I was running with Blue Line to kind of help Hug Wigginton out tonight. I committed to that all season long, and I'm going to stick to it. But all my teammates at Mission One Esports, we always work together. I know I didn't run with them, but I can't thank Hug Wigginton enough. I know I wasn't in a 31 truck tonight. Sucks that Tyler got knocked out there early on in the race, but no matter what, want to give them a shout out. Store-based comics, all those guys, Cops, DSR Electric, everybody that helps us put this thing on. So thank you to everybody.
Absolutely. Brady LaBeouf, the boss man, getting third tonight. Brady, appreciate your time, and we'll see you Monday night at Michigan for the DSR Electric Truck Series.
Yeah, it was some good practice tonight. I'll see y'all then.
All righty, Brady LaBeouf ends up getting third, and now, William, you are standing by with our second-place finisher, Mr. Stephen Thomas.
Yeah, Stephen, second place tonight. Didn't quite have enough to pip Nathan Scott at the line. What more do you think you needed to get past him and take the win tonight?
I don't think whatever I needed I had. He was fast. I'm definitely happy with the second, though, man. It's been a while since I've had a podium finish and been up here in the booth talking to you guys. So I'll take second. But, yeah, man, Nathan was quick.
Yeah, obviously up 14 spots on the night, and obviously second place, still a good result. What's your outlook for these last two Dash for Cash races at Milwaukee and then Daytona before commencing the playoffs?
The same or better, hopefully, man. I've pretty much set myself up for the playoffs to be in a good spot, so we'll just come in and run as hard as we can, not really worried about much, and try to collect a little bit of money and talk to you guys a couple times before the playoffs starts, and then we'll buckle up.
Sounds good, man. Well, anyone you want to thank, sponsors you want to shout out, or, you know, shout outs you want to give for getting that 23 up onto the podium tonight?
Yeah, I want to start with Jersey Smoke and the sponsorship that he helps me out in Monday and Friday nights. DSR Electric and Dan and everything that he does for the league. The Family Handyman, Darren's Nail Gun Repair, Ladenko, A's Lawn and Landscaping, Millie's Restaurant. These are some of the few that help out a lot in this league and Sick With It Motorsports. I want to thank Brady and Cody and everybody that helps out with NASR. I want to thank you guys in the booth, everybody that is involved in NASR 360 Network that broadcasts, I would guess, Monday through Friday at this point. So I want to thank you guys, and I want to thank everybody that's watching, my grandma, Zach, and my wife that watch every Friday, Monday night. Appreciate it, guys.
Awesome. Thanks, man, for the time, and yeah, congrats on that, P2.
Thanks, buddy.
And that was Stephen Thomas. We'll go ahead and bring up the winner. Nathan Scott obviously gets win 31st all the way up to first. Nathan, don't take this the wrong way. We was talking about it in the broadcast booth, but you wasn't our pick. Just want to go ahead and throw that out there, because you actually came out of absolutely nowhere. You didn't qualify. You're up 30 spots. I mean, what was the secret to be able to get the win here tonight at Auto Club?
Well, it was just a long race, and I knew I had time to kind of learn a little bit more about what the truck was going to do. It's kind of why I opted not to qualify, just to see a little more. I didn't have too much practice time heading into tonight, so I had a little time just trying to learn. I saw the cool track temps, so I figured the fall off wouldn't be too great. I mean, it's Fontana, so the fall off is obviously going to happen just because it's a worn out surface, but the cold temperatures, I knew it was going to be tight and a lot of grip at the same time. So heavy pack racing. So avoiding those few big wrecks throughout the first couple of stages was very crucial for me to even have a chance to win the race later on. And then towards the end there, I made contact with the 29. It was just really tight racing for the lead. Everyone trying to get an advantage. I could tell everyone was pushing. I was almost full throttle, and everyone was just right on top of each other. So after pit stops, I just wanted to stretch it out, run it dry. I figured everyone would fall off a little bit, especially after that stage two finish. Dean ran me down and passed me on the last lap, so I knew waiting longer would be the winning move, and I had enough time to get up there, pass Brady, and hopefully hold the gap, and that's what I was able to do.
Now, real quick there, because I'm going to cut in, because I don't get to interview very often, but Nathan, you're like absolute machine, my friend. You sound very like, yeah, it's cool, come. You're coming from the back of the field, my friend. You realize that, you know, I've always said this on air all the time, like, you don't want to be at the back of the pack because there's a massive wreck, you know, you're in it, all of a sudden your machine's all damaged, and, you know, as quick as you possibly are and have been, you're still in trouble, my friend. So that's a lot of confidence to slice your way through the field there and then bring it home at the end.
Yeah, I was very fortunate to have a long race ahead of me, especially there was a few guys moving through the pack with me, but, you know, like, I caught a few lucky breaks there. Starting in the back definitely can be treacherous. It can ruin your race, because when I ran Talladega earlier this season, I started outside of the top 40, and, you know, I ended up in a few incidents, and once I got up there, I got caught right in the middle of a wreck. It took me out. So I was very fortunate to have that happen around me and not at me. And it was tough racing at the front.
Absolutely. Well, Nathan Scott, you end up getting a win here tonight at Auto Club. And before we let you go, you got anybody that you want to thank that made the win possible tonight?
I want to thank Brady for allowing me to run this league and inviting me to run full time in the next seasons. I want to thank my family, my loving girlfriend, and my college, UNLV.
Go UNLV. Nathan Scott ends up getting a win. Nathan, appreciate your time, and hopefully we'll be seeing you a couple more times here in Season 8.
Hope so. Thank you, guys.
And that was Nathan Scott ended up getting the win here tonight. William, your take on what was a fantastic race here tonight at Auto Club.
I mean, that's definitely going to be contender for race of the season here tonight at Auto Club. There was action from start to finish and all throughout the pack. Some unfortunate incidents, but very few yellows, so these guys did a really good job at keeping it clean. And Nathan Scott, absolutely a deserving winner, came up just short in stage number two, but took the checkered flag when it mattered most with an awesome strategic move there to pip out the likes of Stephen Thomas and Brady LaBeouf there, the remainder of the podium sitters. But that sets us up nicely for the last two Dash for Cash races at the Milwaukee Mile and then at Daytona International Speedway. Before the playoffs begin and our top 20 will go fight for a championship here in Season 8 of the COPS Truck Series.
It's going to be an absolute blast to see what happens here the next couple of weeks. Who's going to be able to make it into that top 20? Who's going to surprise us, just like Nathan Scott did here tonight, folks? This is going to conclude the broadcast. Obviously, there you see the schedule. Actually, we'll go ahead and get into that real quick. Auto Club, Milwaukee, Daytona, just like William White said, there you see the schedule. Mark your calendars, folks, for this race in this 2 more weeks. Milwaukee, Daytona. It's going to be an absolute blast to see how these races end up playing out. So mark your calendars. If you ain't got nothing going on Friday nights, get ready. Nazareth 360 Racing Network, I have every bit of it for the Concerns of Police Survivors Truck Series. And if you do have something going on, well, break your plans because you don't want to miss the racing here with Nazareth. Folks, that's going to do it for this broadcast. Obviously, want to thank all the sponsors, Merce Magical Creations, NRE Power, obviously, Goat Locker with what they do within NASRA, obviously, DSR Electric for the sponsorship on the Monday nights, Blanchard's Towing for the sponsorship for the Xfinity Series. Obviously, we want to thank the NASRA 360 Racing Network, Brody LaBeouf, Cody Knott, all our colleagues, Tyler Dittmer, Wesley Outland, Robert Hill Jr., all those guys that are here with us each and every week being the voices of the NASRA 360 Racing Network. Also want to give a shout out to every single one of you out there in the live chat. Appreciate everything y'all do coming in here and watching your friends, your colleagues, your family members, watching them come out here and compete. And shout out to the commentators for always, always putting on one hell of a race each and every night, 5 nights a week. For William White and for the Australian, Dean Biggles, I am the redneck announcer, Jake Reeves, saying as I always say, be safe, be kind, be fast, and we'll see you at the Milwaukee Mile next week.